you've explored the Great Pyramid, escaping its curses, revealing its secrets. You solved a riddle perplexing mankind for ages, the riddle of the Sphinx. In the process, unveiling a treasure sought after throughout the millennia. And with the discovery of a second prophetic scroll, an ominous mystery is unraveling. Now, the epic adventure continues, taking you to the ends of the Earth. Explore mystic ruins, secret societies. Discover sacred sites, sacred rituals. Examine lost cities, lost civilizations. Unearth ancient relics, ancient powers, and solve a lost history. Linking the world's most mysterious locations to a forgotten past. A hidden code prophesying the end of time.
Well, hello, friend. Just relax. You've been out cold for a few days. The blast, do you remember what took place? If not, I'm told it will come back to you slowly at first. It was a sight to behold. You flew back several feet and gave me quite the scare. You might want to lie back down, but not on account of your condition. Do you remember what I said just before you looked inside the Ark? The second scroll. Yes, I thought you would remember. It's fascinating, and during your bed rest, I've had the needed time to interpret this remarkable document. First, the scroll is authentic. A find collectors would literally kill for. But more importantly, the scroll illuminates an incredible historical account, including a rather disturbing prophetical warning. That's the good news. Bad news is that the warning is not the obligatory curse we Egyptologists find commonplace. I've reviewed and reread the text, even tried out radical theories. It all speaks of a very specific event, a devastating past event linked to a dire future. But not in their time, in ours. The ancients knew exactly the date and time, not surprising given the accuracy with which so many ancient cultures recorded the heavens. The Maya precisely recorded and predicted the phases of the moon to this very day. Stonehenge, as you well know, functions as a megalithic observatory, accurately aligning the constellations, planets. The Giza pyramids are in perfect overhead alignment with Orion's belt. The Great Guardian, the Sphinx, gazes upon the constellation of Leo. So I have only to translate the date on the scroll and decipher the warning. But I suspect we may not have the luxury of time. However, you, my good friend, have a critical role in solving this mystery. I've taken the liberty to set you up in several key locations throughout the world. You may have already guessed that they are the locations and civilizations represented on the keys you found in the Great Pyramid, the ones used to open the Chamber of Ages. And you will be accompanied by the Institute's pilot and driver, Humphrey Allen, to several key locations. Hump, as he is affectionately called, will take you wherever you need to go and be there should you need assistance. Additionally, Hump is privy to certain sensitive knowledge necessary for your travels. Well, I've much work to do with the scroll, but I do have a surprise for you, friend. Are you feeling well enough to venture back to the chamber? I can assure you it is worth your discomfort. Come. And here we are again. When we first encountered the Chamber of Ages, I overlooked several key features. After your incident, I noticed two additional rather subtle features. Two precisely cut stone blocks. And one over there. I've managed to pry one open, but the other simply won't budge. The opening is a typical Egyptian crawl space, leading, well, I'll let you discover its contents. However, it holds an item, a disc, of which six are recorded on the second scroll. I could not remove the disc, as it is locked in place. But where the additional discs are, I haven't a clue. I first interpreted the scroll's reference to the six discs as figuratively involving the Egyptian-winged solar disc. But it is evident that these discs really do exist. This whole text makes me uneasy. But it outdates any Greek text I've seen by 1,000 years at least. So I'm hesitant to draw the conclusion, but it is eerily similar. And if I make the assumption that this is the true derivation of Omega, the text consistently references an Omega stone. What type of stone, I have no idea. Well, enough of my rambling. I'd better be on my way. Oh, and should you choose to look inside the Ark this time, do be careful not to touch the inside. It was then that you were thrown back unconscious. I'll be in touch, old friend, by a variety of methods. Hump will make sure you receive everything. And you'll be finding the site passes for each location in your backpack. While you won't have the Ark at your disposal, may God be with you on your exotic explorations.
Thank you. Oh, welcome back. Good to see you again. Yes, yes. Where to now, my friend? Where to? We're out of here.
Ahoy!
Where would you like to sail today, my friend? I'm anxious to get this thing underway. Enough of this bobbing around. Let's get moving.
Thank you.
Let's rock. We're out of here.
Friend, I trust you've outwitted our wide-eyed recruit. Job well done. He is a smart one, but unfortunately, rather immature. How I wish you could spare the time to join me here. But...
Hey, it's go time.
Friend, I trust you've... I hope you're enjoying your time in the warm waters near Bimini. The sonar data we acquired a few months back shows promise.
Time to go! I wondered when we were going to go see Lord Bathelwaite. Let's go.
Yes, yes. What's taken you so long? Gotcha. Gil told me all about you, and from the way he gloated, I expected the second coming of Christ himself. Are you just going to stand there all day, or come in and learn a thing or two? Thank you.
So, you're the bright-eyed, brilliant one that Gil blathers on about all day long. Well, I must say, you managed to gain entry. A feat not easily undertaken. Your wood has just bought you access to my study. Now, if you had the time, which you do now, as Gil has constantly reminded me, you'll find a wealth of rare books and maps at your disposal. Therefore, for the sake of time, I took it upon myself to locate the material regarding the Celts and their history. I've chosen the material based on your task. Yes, Gil let me in on some of what's going on. And the single most important reason for me helping you? My knowledge. My obsession. I've been working on a hypothesis for years. My conclusions? Disturbing. But the key to understanding the misalignment, the calculated misalignment of Stonehenge, is Stonehenge was wound back like a stopwatch.
Gil has mentioned you're finding the Ark. Good show. He asked me to give you information on this as well, as it is an area of interest. An item about which I know a little something. While the Bible gives us history leading up to its disappearance, many wonder where the lost history continues forward. You will, no doubt, come upon that information sooner than you expect, if you haven't already. But as you're pressed for time, be assured that the only date, rather, the only time in history you need be concerned with is when the Ark of our Lord was moved into King Solomon's temple. There are more than a few reasons that that time is significant, but if you look carefully, I'm sure you discover the date and use it to your advantage. You're wasting your time with that nonsense. Come now. Use that brilliant mind of yours. You've no time to waste. Now that one you have there is quite an interesting map. No value on the antiquities market, but a priceless find for those seeking the truth.
Why don't you come back when you have something interesting for me to look at? Between you and I, this Bathelwaite guy's a little off. I'm not sure I'd pay attention to any map I got from him. Come back when you've got something more interesting. That's great. Just what I've been looking for. I can take you there.
trespasser. Be gone.
Do you have anything to show me? Goodbye. No, no. I need to see something first. Thank you very much. No, no. Thank you. That's excellent. Just what I've been looking for. Now I can take you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, back to Stonehenge. We are out of here. Hey, it's go time. We're out of here.
Don't fret, friend. Mr. Rebel, bring in the Ark. This old reactor needs a little power boost from the power source. Stand back, friend.
There you are, my friend. Well, here we are, back where it's all started. You can't imagine the number of people depending on you. And you succeeded, as I knew you would. I've got exciting news for you, my friend. Do you remember the other stone slab I couldn't open? Well, it finally came loose. And what lay behind left me in awe. Casey was right. The Hall of Records, in pristine condition. And that is what I've been involved with for the last few days. You and I will have time to explore this later, but for now, congratulations are in order. Friend, you've seen and experienced what I've only been reading. Well, have you come to the conclusion spelled out in the scroll, which, by the way, I've finally fully and accurately translated? Allow me to connect the dots, although with your intellect, I doubt this will be fresh news. What mysteries have plagued mankind are no longer mysteries. While I still have many questions, I now have a clearer picture of the hows and whys of these ancient civilizations. One of the questions that remain unanswered is how this ancient world empire constructed such a complex power device using a pyramidal design, a self-perpetuating energy source. But rest assured, in the coming months, this structure will be crawling with scientists of every flavor searching for and recording the findings from this unique structure. It is as though a flourishing worldwide civilization vanished, and all that remained was a distant thought of some great empire and the survivors, who in time simply lost the knowledge of their ancestors. Each tribe passing on a distorted iteration of the once sacred knowledge, which eventually became nothing more than legends and myths. The pure knowledge of the Atlantean civilization was never regained, and therefore, each ancient civilization eventually adapted the Atlantean worldview to that of their own set of beliefs, religions, and practices. But many elements, architecture, art, communication, and music, were retained and assimilated as they grew into their own. The Atlantean Empire, as detailed in the scroll, consisted of many tribes, or what we would consider many nations, participating in trade and sailing the Atlantic to do so. They existed, thrived, and spread across the face of the Earth before the devastating event, the initial Omega Stone, so drastically reshaped civilizations to come. Yet the smaller of the two Omega Stones, or what we know now to be two comets, was the first to hit, which hit dead on Santorini, formerly the fabled capital of Atlantis. The impact set off a huge volcanic eruption and an enormous tsunami, unmatched before or to date. The second, significantly larger comet left only a temporary mark on Earth as its shadow ominously, yet calmly, brushed over a planet in upheaval. As Plato accurately recounted millennia ago, in a single day and night of misfortune, the island of Atlantis disappeared into the depths of the sea. The primary capital of Atlantis, along with the sister city at Bimini, simply stopped existing. A powerful empire, the likes of which we've not seen henceforth, literally obliterated in the blink of one's eye. The tribes were cut off from each other, and only a few of each tribe survived the impact and resulting unlivable conditions. The Atlanteans were seafaring peoples, living in and traveling to and from most of the Americas before it was rediscovered by Columbus. Needless to say, he missed the boat, that is, the boats leaving for the Americas before Christ was born. The Phoenicians were even latecomers as compared to the dating of the Atlanteans. And so it goes, the 10,500 BC date is, by all accounts, accurate. This explains the remarkable similarities between these many civilizations, and it also explains why the similarities are oddly unique. In looking at the pyramid at Santorini and comparing it to the Great Pyramid at Giza, and El Castillo at Chichen Itza, it is clear that these other cultures borrowed from the basic form and function of this ancient civilization. And the megaliths at Stonehenge clearly show a similarity to classic Greek architecture, who clearly was influenced by the Atlantean Empire, and who may be accurate in ever claiming to be the descendants of Atlantis. And of course, there is the physical evidence found at Stonehenge of Aegean influence and trade, Egyptian and Phoenician artifacts found in burials nearby. By the islanders' own folklore, it is obvious that Easter Island's native founders were survivors of the destruction. Native Atlanteans adrift after the destruction of Atlantis. Their description sounds identical to that of Plato's. No doubt due to the unprecedented tsunamis when the first comet struck Santorini. And the disappearing planes and ships in the Devil's Triangle now makes sense. The damaged energy source at Bimini was intermittently dispersing strong pulses that would at random down a plane or cause instrument panels to be misread. You see, with the help of the second scroll, it is clear that there was no one Atlantis. However, Stonehenge and Giza were linked to the Aegean Atlantis, and Chichen Itza and Easter Island tied to the Bimini Atlantis. The world has been searching for this lost history to explain the similarities between these cultures. A yearning to believe that an Atlantean culture once flourished. And with this information, history books will surely be revisited in a new light. But our work is not done. While this sheds light on the many archaeological sites we have endeavored to excavate, the scroll makes reference to many archaeological sites located in the east. You will need to rest up, old friend, and you certainly deserve some time away from these crazy jaunts. Oh, and please feel free to revisit the sites if you like. Everything is still as you left it. Then the cleanup won't happen immediately, so you will have the places to yourself, along with Old Hump. Until our next adventure, do take care.